Didn't I say it was the tea that was going to poison him? Didn't I say so? Didn't I say it? I said it. I knew Hugo was going to die. I said it. I did say it. Didn't I say it? See, I told you, look. What's good, everyone? It's Cycles, and I'm back to review Dragon Ball Super Episode 58. So the episode starts off with Goku, Vegeta, and Trunks being knocked the fuck out from their previous fight with Black, right? And they recover through a sensor beam which Bulma gives them. Now, they have a conversation speaking to Bulma, explaining why they're back, why they've been beating the fuck out, you know, just explaining the situation that they're in. But most interesting, they get a visit from Supreme Kai, Beerus, and Whis, right? So here is where the episode gets more interesting. Apparently, according to Whis, they know that Zuno has been visited, and Zuno has been asked about the Super Dragon Balls, and they know that it's Zamas that done it. According to Whis' theory, Zamas pretty much made two wishes. The first wish is to make a replica of Black Goku or Goku, and the second wish is to wish for immortality. Now this would mean that Black is not a Goku from another parallel universe. He is not made from Gohan's dead body, and neither was he created by Zamas himself. Zamas used Dragon Balls to wish for a replica of Goku. Now obviously, after Goku explains the situation that he is in, there's a lot of speculation around the table about what Zamas is doing, what his movements are, based on what he's already done and what he's going to do next, right? So they're kind of predicting his movements. Now this conversation is the most important part of the episode. Since they know that Zamas is cooperating with Black, the way Black got those time rings is kind of self-explanatory now. In order to travel through time, you need those rings and you need to be a Supreme Kai. So they speculate that at some point, Zamas is going to have to turn against his teacher, kill him, steal those earrings, and steal those rings. Now here is very interesting, pay attention, right? In order to travel through time, you have to be a Supreme Kai, which basically means Zamas gives one of his earrings to Black, right? So that makes them both Supreme Kais, which might explain why Black basically calls himself a god or above anyone else. So after all this talking, they just rush off to Universe 10 to speak to Gohan and ask about Zamas' whereabouts, right? And here comes Zamas, quietly in a very calm and collected manner. But before that, he still had that scalpel. Now you can tell from that scene that he already made preparations to come and murder Gohan. However, he wasn't expecting Whis, Goku, and Beerus to show up on the scene. Based on the way he just greeted Gohan, just casually, all calm and collected, we just know this guy's not gonna admit all the shit that he's done or he's planning to do. This guy's just gonna try play dumb as if nothing happened, not knowing that Whis and Beerus already know what this guy's been on. Maybe next episode Beerus might give him a kind warning and say, yo, we know what you're doing, we know your whereabouts, right? We know all this shit you're trying to hold down and shit, it just don't work like that, boy. You better back off now, because I'm well aware that episode titles have been leaked, right? And we know shit is going to go down. But I'll save that for another video, since I don't really want to spoil many people on here. Now, based on the episode preview, I will say this. I was right. I was fucking right. When I was talking about the tea changing colors, yes, I was right. The way Zamas kills Gohan is not necessarily through combat, because Beerus, Whis, and Goku monitor them, right? They leave them alone. Now, based on the preview, it seems as if I was right. As I've mentioned in my previous videos, right, this way Gohan dies is not necessarily through combat. Maybe that might happen as well, but it's through the tea that kept changing colors that I mentioned in my previous video. And I said, the next thing you know, you're drinking this tea, you know it's because Gohan previously mentioned that it was changing flavors, right? It tasted differently, it tasted slightly off, you get what I'm saying? So based on that, on the preview, we find out that after he drinks the tea, because this time it's green, it is the tea that I predicted that would kill him, that ends up killing him, right? All the tea paralyzes Gohan, and Zamas tries to deliver the finishing blow, right? So obviously, after he's done whatever he's done, Goku and the rest probably rush to him and try to stop him before he actually does it. And that's where the beef begins. That's where the fight starts, because you can see Zamas whips out his scalpel that he's been trying to use to kill Gohan when he came out, not knowing that Beerus, Whis, and Goku are going to be there. Even though Zamas is immortal, we know that Goku is stronger, which means, okay, yeah, you're immortal, but that doesn't mean you can't get beat the fuck up. Goku will body you any day. It's just that he can't die from it. The only problem is that eventually Goku will run out of strength and energy. But with Beerus being there, it's kind of hard to say that they're going to lose this one too, because Normally, Beerus wouldn't interfere with this kind of, this sort of business. However, Zamas is trying to do his job, so it kind of, yeah, he is kind of involved. Currently, Zamas doesn't have the power to stop a Super Saiyan Blue like future Zamas does. And I wouldn't really be surprised after Gohan's dead, next victim would have probably been Shin the Supreme Kai from Universe 7. Because if Shin is dead, it means Beerus dies too, which basically gives them access or gives them a way to start doing all the shit that they're doing. Think about future Zamas, the reason why he's doing this shit that, or the reason why he's able to do that shit is because the God of Destruction there died because the Supreme Kai died in a fight against Deborah. I really like this episode. I'm looking forward to the next one, but unfortunately, next time they are on break. Yeah, my reviews are usually 10 minutes long, but it seems people on YouTube have the attention span of a fly, so I have to make it really short. But that's all I have for today. If you really like this review, give it a like. And in the comment section, I really want to know what you thought about this episode, right? Ain't it kind of funny how in this episode, they're doing what Usla has been doing for time, like putting pieces of puzzles together to figure out who Black is, who Zamas is, and stuff like that. Apart from that, I have nothing else to say. Bye.